Well, hundreds of Kenyans from all walks of life converged at Kenyatta International Convention Centre, that's KICC, to witness the swearing-in of the third Deputy President of Kenya, Kithure Kindiki.
They were generally excited about Kindiki's ascension. Kenyans across the country aired varying views, with some lauding the move, with some claiming the exercise should have been halted until a ruling was made on the impeachment of the former Deputy President.
Friday morning in the central business district of Nairobi, a section of Kenyans deserted their businesses to witness the swearing-in of the third deputy president of Kenya, Professor Kithure Kindiki. Men in boots manned every entrance of the Kenyatta International Convention Centre to ensure the safety of those in attendance. Hundreds of Kenyans across the country, armed with the Kenyan flag, turned up for the event. Those who were going in had to undergo a series of security checkups before being escorted to the venue. Despite being hit by the scorching sun, dignitaries and citizens waited patiently as different music bands entertained the audience. From his residential home in Karen, the man of the hour made his way through the deserted roads of Nairobi to his former office before marching to KCC. On his way, he saluted a few dignitaries and headed to the convention's waiting lounge, waiting for the arrival of the head of state. After the arrival of the president, the man of the hour, Professor Kindiki, joined the celebration dressed in a navy blue suit, white shirt and a red tie, accompanied by his spouse, Joyce Kindiki, who was dressed in an off-white dress. In a spot check by KBC Channel 1, a section of Kenyans who turned up for the ceremony lauded the High Court's move to lift the conservatory orders barring the swearing-in of Kindiki.
Tumefanya vizuri koti kwa sababu hii mambo inadirisha mambo mingi yenye ingekuwa inaendelea. Kitu tunahitaji Kindiki, Professor Kindiki, awe imara, afuatilie kitu rais anamwambia, wafanye kazi pamoja.
Tulikuwa tumekaa tukiongojea sana tuone uamuzi wa mahakama. Mahakama imepitisha na sisi tunakubaliana na mahakama, watu wapishe tuendelee mbele.
Hii ni kitu imekuja kutuonyesha ya kwamba Kenya tunaendelea kukoma kidemokrasia na kutuonyesha kwamba hakuna mtu hawezi akaondolewa katika mamlaka hata without vita.
Tumefikia mahali tunataka kuangalia mbele. Lililofanyika limetendeka. Ikiwa mtu hamtaki mkubwa wake mdogo wake aende mbele, tuendelee Kenya iende mbele, kazi mahali zilikuwa zimesimama ziendelee.
However, some had a different opinion.
There is an element of subordination, being humble to your boss. It has come even to the limelight, even during working with the president, he was feeling like a co-president, not a deputy president. So it is also a virtue Kindiki should learn, that when you are working with a president, you are not a president, you are not a co-president, you are a deputy president.
If I was to be asked, we scrap this DP post, president, achaguliwe peke yake vile alikuwa anachaguliwa, alafu anaendesha serikali vile anataka kuendesha. Badala ya kuweka mtu kama huyu rigadi sasa, pressure sana.
Tumeona kwamba mambo mengi yamesimama, so hatujui akiapishwa mambo itakuwa sawa ama itakuwa vile vile, lakini matarajio yetu tunataka tu mambo ikue sawa, kazi iendelee kwa sababu biashara imesimama sana.
After the celebrations, you could see the symbolism of power in the deputy president's escort as he headed out of KCC in the company of the president. Kindiki becomes the third deputy president of Kenya after the impeachment of his predecessor. Kasichana Masha, Easy Friday.